With your left arm, think of it as a lever, and the fulcrum of the lever is your elbow. So your elbow tucked in as much as you can against your body, rather than out there like that. So in here, and you use your arm like that as a lever, rather than having your elbow out here, which means you have to like pull the bellows in, out, pull the bellows out and push it back in. With the lever kind of idea, and your wrist is against the strap, you're actually more pushing the bellows rather than out there and pulling, okay? I find that is way less tiring and also makes a whole lot of other aspects for getting a sound on your bass box a whole lot easier. So I'll maybe just turn around back. Yeah. What I find is using this lever idea, so my wrist is under the strap rather than, say, the back of the hand. So I guess fairly far forward, elbow by the side, wrist under the strap. And so what I have is like another, I guess, fulcrum, which is the heel of the palm of my hand. Okay, now I've got the glove off. Yeah, the heel of the palm, kind of around this area here, is against the bass box, and that provides a little bit of movement for, say, angling around. And see, that gives you actually an awfully long way that you can get in terms of chord spread. Yeah. So I'll show you just a basic chord thing, like maybe C minor, F minor, G7. Yeah. So C minor, then the buttons next to that, and then moving up one. So you can see, even just doing that, the kind of movement that my hand is doing. Yeah, that's very exaggerated. As I mentioned earlier, the notion of like pushing the bellows outwards, you'll see that the strap gets pushed out a little bit by my wrist kind of bending out towards that way as I'm pushing it. And there's then coming back, the heel of the palm is pushing against the box coming back. So you can see there's a bit of a difference in the tension of the strap for going in and out. Thank you. there's one more thing, which is the whole, you mentioned that you find it easier to move going up the bass box than down. What I can suggest is that in terms of moving, you know, I started wearing this glove mainly because the skin on the back of my hand was just really suffering from being underneath the strap all the time because I spend a lot of time playing. So I started wearing a glove. It affords a little bit of protection for the skin. But what I discovered subsequent to that, as soon as I put the glove on, that movement on the bass box is a whole lot more fluid just because you've got some fabric between your skin and, you know, whatever this material here is, which is kind of, you know, it's sticky-ish for skin. So I find that actually the glove is great. It just makes life a whole lot easier in many ways. I think maybe the other thing about moving upwards or downwards is that as soon as you have your elbow out and you're pulling the bellows, okay, that makes any kind of movement very difficult because I think when you're pulling, you lose contact with the bass box. Your hand, because it's pulling the strap out, you lose contact with the bass box of that part of your hand there, the palm. Whereas if you use the lever thing and you're like pushing, you really do keep some contact with the bass box. And so sliding and judging where you're going to, I find a lot easier by just staying in touch with the bass box as much as possible. Now, I know that you're a pianist, which I used to be as well, and there's one really very important issue for piano players who take up the accordion, which is when you play the piano, just about everything that you do involves the arm and the hand working in pretty much the same manner. You know, you make an attack on the keyboard, and so the arm and the hand are driving that. When you're playing the accordion, the arm and hand are, I suppose, really doing quite different things. The bellows, often you're needing to have just as a continuous motion, or perhaps even, you know, doing dead stops for accents. Meanwhile, your hand, your fingers, are doing quite an independent action. So it's really important to just, you know, do a little bit of exercises, you know, a minute or so a day, depends how much you want to practice, of just thinking of this left arm as being like, if you've ever watched any string players, like a violin player, the bellows arm is like the arm on the violin which plays the bow, okay? It's producing the sound. So that needs to be one action, which for us is our left arm movement and movement of the bellows. And what you're doing with the buttons is, in a way, totally unrelated to that. So physically and for the brain, it's a little bit of an issue to get around. I think you need far more finger independence playing the accordion than you do to play the piano, I guess is what I'm saying. That's the short version. Okay. Hope all that helps.